I could hear the music playing as I came up to the door. And once inside, I felt the beat of feet up on the floor. Had Gal himself been there that night, he couldn't have disapproved. As sets of reels got settled and the bows began to move, the fiddlers fired the music to each corner of the bar, and the rhythm swung like bassy on piano and guitar. Keening bright above the rest, the small pipes led the splore. The call went up for dancers, Frank and Maggie took the floor. The players stopped to catch their breath, and the dancers gasped for air. The piper stood and loosed his straps, and stowed his pipes with care. And as he stepped towards the bar, a voice was heard to say, "You look to me the kind of man could play a sweet Strathspey. Well, I have that reputation and it's kind of you to say, but I've got a demon thirst on me, I haven't got all day. Well, hold that drink a minute now and look at what I've here. A set of pipes worth more your time than any pint of beer. The drones are turned from boxwood and the chanters bound with gold. Finest beeswax, hemp and leather, here I'll give you them to hold." The piper looked in wonder as those pipes came out the case. He strapped them on and closed his eyes, and quiet fell the place. The devil in the kitchen and the wrathy Marcus rant, George the Fourth and Stumpy and the bubble fetter cairn. As each Strathspey outshone the last, he swore he knew no more. But still the tunes came tumbling out from some forgotten store. He played Strathspeys and reels and jigs he never thought he knew. And when at last the outpour stopped, the silence around him grew, until the shock of what they'd heard from everyone did burst, and cheers and yells and shrieks and stamps, which by and by dispersed. And as they did, the piper turned and to the maker said, "What enchantment is there here, and was it really me who played? There's fearful stories of these things I've heard the old folk tell. I fear the hands that made these pipes were guided straight from hell." Well, the maker smiled at him and said, "I understand your fear, but the wood and leathers of this earth, no magic is there here. I will admit these pipes could be the finest ever made, but that would count for not one thing if they were never played. For there's music in them right enough, but there's music in you too, and the one requires the other for that music to come through." The pipes unlocked the music that was waiting in your soul, and you unlocked the instrument and made